There are many different ways to get ahead as a student at university or college. Whether you're going to university or college or you are currently there, note-taking applications can be a great way for you to jump in and get better organized as well as use smarter recall of information with AI technologies. Today, we're going to help you pick the best note-taking applications as a student and really optimize your daily productivity. So welcome, my name is Francesco D'Alessio and welcome to Toolfinder. If you're new here to the channel, please do hit subscribe down here and feel free to check out all the apps below that we're gonna recommend in this video. Now, naturally, some of these include affiliate links, so do make sure to check that out below. And of course, we're one of the best places to find productivity tools. So if you're interested, jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more. Even wider range of note-taking apps. So the first one on our list is one that is highly specified for students and it's called RemNote. Now this application is sort of like Notion in its look and feel. You can create these notes with images, even add PDFs, and really link them together, which is what you can do with apps like Notion. The real difference is that RemNote has something called flashcards, which you can turn any of your notes or elements of their notes, even images, into flashcards. And it's also got some neat AI features that'll help you to save time creating all those flashcards for you to go across every single day. Now there are analytics flashcards helping you to recall them at specific times designed around something called spaced repetition. And it's a really effective tool for not just helping you take notes, but recall those notes when you're trying to revise for an exam. The second application is Microsoft OneNote. And for many students, if you're at a university or college that has a Microsoft license, which means that they use Microsoft as their general experience to manage email and things like that and storage. You may know this if you've got a OneDrive access. You'll also have access to something called Microsoft OneNote. And this is a very simple note-taking application that allows you to organize all of your notes into notebooks, organize them a little bit like a folder system. But most importantly, it does have features in the premium that allow you to access Copilot, which is a Microsoft built product, which essentially uses AI to help you ask questions about the notes you're taking. Now, this is a really effective option. And for those who want a free, great note-taking application, especially those who are on Windows devices, will really find benefit with Microsoft OneNote. Next up is one called Supernotes. Now, Supernotes has a generous free plan with 100 cards to get you started. And the benefit to this application is whilst you can take lovely cards and manage them, even create a journal type experience with daily notes, you can also share your notes with other people. And this is great for if some of your peers have missed a lecture and you want to share it with them so that they can have them access in their Supernotes and even collaborate together on them. This is a great way to bundle all of those in one location. It's also good if you're collaborating together on them and you want to build the notes out a little bit more. So Supernotes, a really interesting option and really well designed for pretty much all devices. Now, we have missed out on talking about Notion. It is a free application that students with aec.uk email addresses or edu email addresses can get access to an academic student account, which will allow them more bonuses as part of their experience. But you get unlimited blocks and you can use templates to build up these workspaces for not just notes, but planning as well. For note taking, there's these things called databases, which can help customize the way that you take your notes, as well as the web clipper for allowing you to capture stuff. And you can pretty much bring anything into databases as well to help you take the most effective notes. There's even, for $8 additional a month, a AI feature which helps you to ask questions about your notes. And this can be great for recall as well, especially when it comes to revising based on the notes you've taken. So number five is one called Goodnotes. Now, Goodnotes is well known for being an iPad stylus-friendly experience, but it is also available on multiple other tablet-based devices. But this is one of the best for those who like and are visual thinkers when it comes to taking notes. It is really well built and is in its sixth version now and allows you to, on iPad and other devices, be able to take these beautiful sketch-based notes as well as adding text around them. This is perfect for bringing your notes to life and sharing them with others. And there's also AI features as well, which help to improve your handwriting and make it look less amateur, even if you're not so good at the old sketching. It is really reasonably priced too, at $9.99 per year, which makes it one of the most cost-effective premium apps on the list in this video. Number six is one called BearNotes. Now, this one is great for those who want a simple yet powerful note-taking application. It has got a great system for organizing your notes in hashtags, maybe a little bit too old for students now, but in general, you can use this experience to help organize your notes and break them down. You can also add images, tables, latex, and also additional syntaxes, which is useful for those who need it. But most importantly, this is a free application available for iOS and Mac that's going to get you through a good experience. It works offline, it's very functional, and even has sketch abilities on the iPhone and the iPad version, which is great for bringing your notes to life. Many people also find the premium really reasonable at $29.99 per year. Now, next up is one called Obsidian. This is probably for the more detailed researchers, those students who may be in masters or PhDs or doing a very research intensive topic as part of their university or college studies. And this one is really good because you can link notes up and build a graph view, which helps bring to life your notes in this brain-like structure. A lot of people like it as well because it's got a canvas mode, which allows you to pull all of your ideas together, including media like images and videos, to help bring those notes to life. Many people also like that you can customize it, and the best thing about it is it's free and local first, which means it's stored locally on your device, which makes it easy to access. And you can upgrade as well for the premium, which gives you access to end-to-end encryption between your notes. Now, again, a more serious note-taking application, but Capacities, another note-taking application, a little bit like Obsidian. It has a PKM focus, which allows you to bring your notes together and connect them in a graph view. But the one thing that it does do is create your notes based on objects. So you could add a meeting or a study note, or even connect a person that you commonly speak to as part of your account and build those connections up so that you can see the relationships forming between your notes. It's almost like having a real life note-taking system that is based around objects. Many people are liking this application as well because it's got a journal-like ability and it looks very much like Notion as a base, which a lot of people like when getting started. Next up is Amplenote, and many people consider this one to be looking a little bit clunky, but it has some many powerful features below it. It is a free note-taking application, which does have reasonable premium abilities compared to some of the other options in this list. But Amplenote has not just notes, but also tasks and calendar. This is great if you're wanting to add tasks, because there's something called a task score in this, which allows you to add all of your notes and your tasks to those notes. And each time you add a task, you can add attributes to it and it ranks it, which is very helpful, giving it a score each time you add it, which is an incredibly useful feature. It's also got a way to time block for your tasks and your notes in one location, which a lot of people like. Finally, our recommendation as well is Lunar Task. Now, this also combines tasks and notes in one location, and it's more of a simple note-taking software for helping you to get started. It's also got a journal ability, which a lot of students like, and it's very promising for those who have ADHD, as it really maps to some of the best systems that those with ADHD typically thrive with. This application also has tasks and projects and other abilities which are going to help enhance your productivity at university or college. So thank you so much for stopping by. I hope that we helped you to narrow down your options. And if we didn't, then there are loads of different note-taking apps over on toolfinder.co for you to help narrow down your choices. And hopefully we can help you find one there. So thanks so much for stopping by. I hope you have a lovely rest of the day and happy studies whilst you're at college or university. Thank you very much. Cheerio.